MongoDB is an integral part of Appsmith's versatile architecture. It serves as the reliable companion that supports our system. MongoDB's flexible and scalable NoSQL solution seamlessly integrates with Appsmith, serving as the backbone for data storage. I'm Kevin Blanco, Senior DevRel Advocate here at Appsmith, and today I'm going to explain how MongoDB powers all the Appsmith applications out there, regardless of the deployment scenario, self-hosted or on the cloud, with the community, enterprise or business edition, and how you can self-host Appsmith using MongoDB Atlas as the database provider. This video delves into MongoDB's crucial role in the Appsmith ecosystem, emphasizing its reliability and performance across all instances. Appsmith is deployed as a single Docker container with a single volume for storing persistent data and also houses all five processes in one image via SupervisorD. We call this the modular monolithic architecture. Appsmith runs an embedded instance of MongoDB for data storage inside the Docker container, but you can also decouple it to external instances and run Appsmith in a serverless, stateless architecture. Using external instances makes the Appsmith container stateless, enabling better performance and scalability. So now, let's take a look on how is this made. All right, go to cloud.mongodb.com and sign up for a free account or log in with your credentials. I'm going to use Google because that's how I authenticate in MongoDB Atlas. And once we are in, you're going to be able to create a new cluster or use an existing cluster that you have in your project. Now, for testing purposes, we do recommend that you use the free and shared instance or clusters. But obviously, for production workloads, we recommend that you do not use the free or shared clusters from MongoDB. We recommend a paid cluster. Now, head to Database here on the left menu. And here you will see the information about your deployments, if you have any. If you don't have, you can create a new deployment. But I already have my cluster here, so I'm going to go to Browse Collections, and I'm going to create a new collection for this specific sample that I'm doing. I already have a couple of collections here, but I'm going to create a new database for that sake. And I'm going to call it Appsmith Local, as well the collection name, and hit Create. Now remember that name because we're going to need it for the connection string. So there you go. Very quickly, we have our collection inside our cluster. Now let's go to the configuration for the network access because we need to allow connections to our cluster. Now again, for testing purposes, we're going to allow connections from anywhere, but that's not desired for production workloads. For example, I have this Google Cloud Run instance that is only allowing connections from this specific IP address, and that's the way it should be from a security standpoint on any production project or workload. But again, for this specific test right here, I'm going to allow access from anywhere. And you can see it's going to use the wildcard IP range to allow connections from anywhere. So I'm going to confirm this, and this is going to take a couple of minutes. So while that happens, we can go back to our database information and see the connect button over there. If you click there, you will be able to see the different mechanisms to connect to our cluster. For example, with Compass or with Shell or MongoDB for VS Code. But if we go to the drivers one, and scroll down below, you will see your connection string. This is the one you want to copy, and we're going to use in Appsmith to connect to MongoDB Atlas. But there's one thing that is really important to notice here. As you can see, you have your username, your password, which is hidden. You can click here to see your password, and then you have the URL for the domain. But after the slash, you do not see the actual collection name we created. Remember, we called it Appsmith Local, but that's not as part in this connection string. So now when you copy it, remember that you need to put after the slash the collection name. That's the only thing that it's missing here, and the parameters we want to keep them as well. So with that said, we can now close here and go back to the network access. And there you go, we confirm that the change is applied. So now let's go to Appsmith and connect to this cluster right here. Okay, so here I have my Appsmith local instance. It's running locally using Docker, and I just installed it, and it has the basic first application created. Now you want to go to the admin settings here on the left, and there you will see the advanced section. That is where the configuration for the MongoDB URI and the Redis URL lives. Also the custom domain configuration. So as you can see here, Appsmith locally is connected to the embedded MongoDB database inside the Docker container. And you can see that this is the credentials over here. All we have to do is just remove this and add our database credentials that we copy from MongoDB Atlas. Now, remember what I said before, that it didn't have the collection name on the URI. So as you can see here, right after the domain slash, here's the database collection name. And this is also important parameters here. Not only the ones that MongoDB Atlas gave us, but also a couple more. The first one is this W here for the writes equal majority, retry writes equal true, outsource equal admin, and the minimum pool size equals 0. Now these parameters are important for Appsmith to run perfectly. So now all you have to do is just go and save this configuration, and what Appsmith is going to do is restart, and it's going to analyze that first of all the connection worked, and secondly is going to analyze all of the different configurations that we had in place in the embedded MongoDB. So now that it's saved, what's going to happen is Appsmith is going to analyze what information we had existing in our embedded database in the Docker container image, and it's going to migrate the data from that database into the MongoDB Atlas. Now, depending on how much applications, data sources, users, roles, etc. you have already created in your existing instance, that might take a while. So we can go to the, for example, container logs and see what's happening. As we can see here on the logs, we will notice that once we saved, Appsmith is going to understand, all right, it looks like the MongoDB connection changed. So it's going to start the migration sequence. That migration sequence, like I said, analyzes everything we had stored on the embedded MongoDB, and is going to start migrating every single thing that lives there into the other MongoDB instance that we have in MongoDB Atlas. And you will be able to see all of the different steps that it's doing, for example, analyzing the configuration and plugins and data sources, and it's going to start migrating each of those one by one. You will be able to read the logs because, like I said, this process might take some time. Since I have just a starting version of Appsmith without not much applications, without not much data sources, this process probably is going to take a few minutes. But if you have a large data set already created in your Appsmith instance, that might take a while. So you can keep looking at the logs and just also refresh your browser until that's done. All right, it looks like the process just finished, and let's give it a try. Let's refresh the page here, and we go back to the admin settings and the advanced section once again. We will see that the connection string is in place, and if we go back to general, we will see that the basic application that I had is already there. If we go back to MongoDB Atlas, we can confirm that the data has been migrated and is working on that specific cluster we created. Let's click Browse Collections and remember that we are using the MongoDB Appsmith local collection. And as you can see, it now has other names here, other collections. For example, we have all of the different fields that Appsmith creates in order to run properties. For example, if we click here on application, we can see that we have our first application information is already there. Everything is looking good. And let's do something on this application to see if we can also make sure that everything is saving properly. For example, we can create a new data source. I'm going to use these users testing data source that Appsmith always has. And as you can see, we have here the users table. If we go back to MongoDB Atlas, let me refresh just to make sure that everything is loading properly. And under Appsmith local, if we go to data source, we should see that the new data source is being created here. As you can see, the user's name, data source, and we can see all of the information about that data source. So that means that it's working properly. We're now working with Appsmith on a detached mode or on a decoupled way. So we could deploy this Appsmith application, connect to the same MongoDB Atlas instance, and that way none of the changes we've made are lost. That means we can recover, we can do scalability and many other benefits from running Appsmith on a serverless or detached or decoupled mechanism. So there you go. Today you learn how easy it is to change the default database that Appsmith uses from the embedded MongoDB to MongoDB Atlas. Thank you so much and stay tuned for more tutorials and videos about Appsmith running on a serverless and detached mode. Have a great one.